Hello, Carlita. How are you?
How are you, teacher?
I'm fine. Nice to see you.
Me too.
Okay, thank you. Ok, Carlita, tell me the alphabet. Vamos a repasar.
Ok, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, A, I, J, K, L, M, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, W, X, Y, Z.
Solo una. ¿En cuál crees que se equivocó?
Después de JK, por ahí, creo. ¿Verdad?
Se comió la I.
Okay.
Thank you, Carlitos. Tell me the alphabet, please. Carlitos. Carlos Membriño.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Hi. ¿Tengo que decir el alfabeto?
Yes.
Ok. Voy entrando. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, A, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, W, X, Y, C.
Excellent. En la misma. I. Ok. En esa tuvimos problema, la I.
Sí.
Hay que repasarlo, ¿ok? Carla, tell me the alphabet, please. Carla. Okay. Welcome, Laura and Mateo. Okay, don't worry, Carlita. I understand. Okay, let's see. Laura, tell me the alphabet.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Excellent.
Singing.
La verdad que sí, ok. Excellent. Pero un día le voy a preguntar así, porque cuando uno se lo aprende cantado, el detalle es que no se las puede, o sea, se las puede en orden.
Yeah.
Pero muy bien, excellent, thank you. Mateo, tell me the alphabet. Mateo, hello.
Hello.
Hello, Mateo. Tell me the alphabet.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, W, X, Y, N, Z.
Excellent. Thank you. Veronica, tell me the alphabet.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, A, L, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z.
Okay, thank you. Excellent, okay? Anayansi, tell me the alphabet. Anayansi?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. Tell me the alphabet, please.
Okay. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, I, J, K, L, N, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, W, X, Y, C.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. Let's see. Two more. Okay, Jancy Mayen.
Buenas tardes.
Sí, buenas tardes, señorita. Necesito hablar con el teniente Vargas.
Thank you. Okay, let's see. Una más. Jancy, tell me the alphabet. No, 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 right? Janet, sorry, Janet.
Sorry, miss.
Ah, Janet. First, hello, Janet. First Jancy and then Janet, please tell me the alphabet.
Okay. First me?
Yes.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, F, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, W, X, Y, Z.
Okay, thank you. Janet.
A, B, C, D, F, G, H, A, J, K, M, M, O, P, Q, R, S, W, Y, Z.
Okay, thank you. Okay, guys. Homework. You have to learn the alphabet, right? Algunos sí, sí solo es una letra, pero otros sí necesitamos mejorar, ¿verdad? Decir, porque en un dictado hay palabras que no se conocen. Entonces, el maestro lo que va a hacer es deletreársela. ¿Yes?
Yes.
Entonces, por eso es necesario saberse el alfabeto y algunos sonidos de las letras, así empiezan las palabras, o si no, son bien, o sea, son bien, llevan bastante fuerza en esa letra. Entonces, por eso es necesario aprenderse el alfabeto. Así que, tarea. Y se lo dije en la primera clase, ¿se acuerdan? Tarea. Ok. Homework. Ok. Let's see. Okay, it's time for an activity. Let's see. I'm going to dictate you three sentences. Les voy a dictar three sentences. Okay, three sentences. Okay, I'm going to read three times. Okay, first, just, I'm going to read and you have to listen and recognize the words. And the second time, you have to write the sentence. In the third time, you have to check. Yes?
Yes.
First, listen. Okay. Let's see. Number one. Okay, number one, John finished work at 5 o'clock and then he came home. Okay. Number two, I was so tired that I fell asleep during the movie last night. Number three. Excuse me, but I think you forgot to bring me a spoon with my soup. Number four. Tommy, did you finish your homework? Number five. He doesn't look very well. Maybe he should see a doctor. Did he take any medicine? Okay. Now it's time to write. Number one. John finished work at 5 o'clock and then he came home. Voy a repetir. John finished work at 5 o'clock and then he came home. Okay. Number two. I was so tired that I fell asleep during the movie last night. I repeat. I was so tired that I fell asleep during the movie last night. Number three. Excuse me, but I think you forgot to bring me a spoon with my soup. Again. Excuse me, but I think you forgot to bring me a spoon with my soup. Number four. Tommy, did you finish your homework? Tommy, did you finish your homework? Okay, number five. He doesn't look very well. Maybe he should see a doctor. Did he take any medicine? He doesn't look very well. Maybe he should see a doctor. Did he take any medicine? Okay. I'm going to read the again, okay? Listen and check. Number one, John finished work at 5 o'clock and then he came home. I was so tired that I fell asleep during the movie last night. Number three, excuse me, but I think you forgot to bring me a spoon with soup. Number four, Tommy, did you finish your homework? And number five, he doesn't look very well. Maybe he should see a doctor. Did he take any medicine? Okay. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to write it. At 5 o'clock. At 5 o'clock, and then He came, para que la revisen. He came home. This is number one, okay? Number one.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes.
The name John, no va al final la H. No.
In this case, I guess que va de las dos formas, porque este es un ejercicio que yo encontré y lo escribe de esa forma. J-O-H-N. ¿Ok? Ok, let's see number two. I was so tired. I was so tired.
Yes. That I feel. Well.
Asleep.
I fell asleep.
I fell
during
the movie last night.
The movie last night.
I have a question.
Uh-huh.
Fell or fell?
Fell asleep? Fell asleep.
Uh-huh. F-E-L-L.
W-L.
Yes. Yes, double L.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Number three.
I sleep bajunto, teacher.
Yes.
Sí, okay.
Yes, asleep. Excuse me, se me perdió. But I think you
forgot. You forgot.
You forgot
my phone.
To bring me a spoon with
my soap. My soap.
Number four.
Mm-hmm.
Tommy, ¿se acuerdan de estos? Ayer los estuvimos viendo, ¿huh?
Yes. Did you finish your homework?
Your homework. It's a question, right? Number five. He doesn't.
Teacher, I'm sorry. Uh-huh. Homework no lleva K.
Yes.
Me lo comí. Sorry. Es que como las escogí así para que no se acordaran así el orden. Por eso me he costado encontrarlas. Okay. Look.
Very well.
Look very. Very well, right? Uh-huh.
Maybe.
See a doctor.
Maybe. Maybe he should see a doctor. Did he take any medicine? Okay, how many mistakes?
1, 2,
and four
miss.
Four, okay.
Tommy could be with Y at the end.
Which one?
Tommy, T-O-M-Y.
Which one? In which one?
Number four. I brought Tommy with Y, no E.
Mm-hmm. Tommy. Number four.
Tommy. Ah. The name Tommy.
Tommy. Pero son mistakes, son errores de estar digitando en el momento, ¿ok?
No, pero que yo preguntaba por si era la forma correcta de escribirla.
No, entonces yo no, me había equivocado. No, yo me equivoqué. Sorry. Yo, tome, yo, what? ¿Dónde? ¿Ok? Ajá, guys. Yes.
Pika, asleep teacher. Asleep.
¿Qué pasó?
Que, o sea, I feel asleep. ¿Qué significa esa frase?
Me sentía sonolienta.
Que era a sleep. O sea, yo pensé que era a sleep, no asleep.
Asleep. Es que en ese caso, okay, les voy a explicar más a fondo, sí, pero necesito ver otra cosa, porque si no, come el tiempo, ¿ok? Prometo que ya después de esto, ¿ok? Ok. Aquí estamos, ¿ok? Guys. Lo voy a anotar antes que se me olvide. Ok. Asleep. Guys. When do we use verb to be?
Feelings. Condition, states, and description. Description.
How is it?
Yes.
In habit. Habit.
No. Remember, verb to be.
Ser o estar.
Yes, ser o estar. Ajá. Uh-huh. When do we use? Yes. When we describe someone? Yes. For example, characteristics, yes, we talk about how a person look.
You are intelligent, yes.
Look like, right? What about feelings? I am
happy.
I am happy. I am sad. I am angry. I am
boring.
I am boring. I am tired, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Yes.
What else? When we talk about characteristics, physical characteristics, for example, I am tall, I am thin, I am fat, I am fit. Yes? What else?
In a state, I'm single. Marian.
No. Yes, when we talk about state, yes. I'm single, I'm married. What else?
And conditions.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Tell me an example.
You are rich.
Yes.
I'm poor.
Yes, when we talk about the social status, yes. So, let's see. Yes, I'm tired. What about, and when we talk about estar? Uh-huh. For example, where are you? ¿Dónde están ustedes?
In my house.
I am at home. For at example, home. If you are working right now, I am
at work.
I am at work. Uh-huh. In the case I'm talking about Carla, I said Carla is at work. Yes? Okay, let's see. Let's describe someone. Let's see. Let's talk about a famous person. For example, okay, let's see. Chespirito. I know. No, él está muerto, ¿no? Pero lo vamos a describir después, okay? For example,
let's see. She's a comedian.
Yes, yes. Pero mejor cuando usemos el was, lo vamos a describir a él. Alguien que esté vivo, que sea famoso, let's see.
Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey? Yes. Let's talk about Jim Carrey. Uh-huh. Let's describe him.
He's a funny.
He's funny.
He is funny, yes. Uh-huh.
He's
what
a
else?
He's a comedian.
Yes, he is a comedian. Yes.
He's a clown.
Yes, right. Why not?
He's tall.
He is tall. Uh-huh.
He's thin.
He's thin. Yes. Uh-huh. He is intelligent. Yes.
He's very intelligent.
Yes, a lot. What else?
Actor is happy.
He is an actor. Excellent.
He's not happy.
He's not happy, right?
No.
Yes.
Why not?
Cayó en depresión.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit strange, right? Es un poco raro, igual que William. Robbie Williams.
Robbie,
yes, igual que Robbie Williams, era así como que súper feliz y todo, y de repente salió con. Ok. Complicado, right? Ok. What else? Let's see, let's talk about another famous person. What about Cameron Diaz?
She's beautiful.
She's beautiful
woman.
Yeah.
She's tall.
She is intelligent. Of course.
She's blondie.
She is blondie. Uh-huh. She is an excellent actress. Yes.
She is funny.
She is funny. Uh-huh. You see? O sea, cuando describimos. Cuando describimos a una persona, tenemos que utilizar el verbo to be, ¿ok? Porque significa, es parte del ser, ¿sí? Yo soy, tú eres, ¿sí? A eso se refiere. Entonces es totalmente diferente cuando hablamos del simple present, porque el simple present yo lo uso para daily routine, hobbies and habits. En cambio, el verbo to be es cero, estar en todo el sentido, ¿ok? We are talking about a verb to be in ser, ¿okay? But what happens with the past of verb to be?
Uh-huh. It's the same, but in past.
It's the same, but in past. Uh-huh. For example, we can talk about Chespirito because he's not alive. Okay? Él está muerto, okay? We can say he was, yes? Mm-hmm. Yes, he was a good actor. Okay, let's see. We have the persons or the pronouns here. Okay, let's say the first person singular is I. Uh-huh. Remember, first person singular, I. Second person singular,
you.
You. Okay, you. You. Just one person. Okay, third person in singular,
he, she, it.
Yes. What about first person in plural?
We.
When I'm talking about, for example, my friends, my family, but I include myself. Okay? Voy incluido yo. What about second plural? Second person in plural.
You.
You, okay? Ah, pero es el mismo, no. I'm here in the second person in singular, I'm talking about one person. Just you. You, Carla. You, Jancy. Okay, you, Carlos. And when I'm talking about the second person in plural, I'm talking about all of you, okay? You, I'm including Carla, Jancy, Ana Jancy, Carlos, Daniel, Kathy, yes?
But no, you, oh yes.
No, en este caso, yo no, yo entro en we, si yo me incluyo, okay? Yeah. What about third person in plural?
They,
they. They. Cuando yo no me incluyo, ok. Se son ellos, ok. Ok, in first person singular, I use was. Was, yes, remember.
Miss is was or was.
Was, was. Esa es la schwa.
La schwa. Okay.
La schwa. Ya saben cuál es la schwa, ¿verdad?
Yes.
En el teclado no la puedo hacer, ¿verdad? Es como así como un golpe.
El aire a uno.
Yes. Was. Was. Es como. Was.
Was.
In the second person singular, that is you, we use were. What about the third person singular?
Was.
Was, yes, of course. What about we?
Were.
Were. You.
What?
Were.
You. Were. What about they?
They were.
They were. Yes. Remember, remember. A veces nos pasa que cuando estamos hablando, porque ya los nervios, escribiendo así bajo presión, se nos olvida que muchas veces he, she, it puede ser otras cosas. Yo puedo utilizar nombres, yo puedo utilizar nombres, puedo hablar de mi perro, puedo hablar de mi hermana, en el caso de she, mi mamá, mi prima, yes, mi hija. And when we talk about he, I can say my dad, my brother, my friend, yes?
Yes.
What about we? My?
My person, all of us, all of us. My family?
All of us, my family and?
And me.
And me.
Yes. I can say that, okay? Entonces esas cosas son las que a veces se nos pasan por alto, okay? What about when I talk about they?
My friends?
My when friends.
When I say Anna and Joe, yes. They are.
Yes, I'm talking about they. They were. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, in present day. They are in past. They were. Yes, it's okay. Okay. Let's see the affirmative form. In the affirmative form, I need what? The structure. Uh-huh.
Affirmative.
Subject,
verb and past.
Verb to be in past.
Verb to be in past.
Plus
complement.
Complement, okay. Yo quiero que ustedes practiquen, yo quiero que ustedes repitan, porque, o sea, no quiero yo solo estar hablando, porque va a llegar un momento en que va a ser tedioso, es así como que oírla, vaya. Y más el cansancio que tienen del trabajo, yo sé que es bien difícil porque yo los entiendo. Entonces yo quiero que ustedes, aunque yo sé que ya lo saben, pero que ustedes lo practiquen, que ustedes incluso lo repitan. Yo les decía la otra vez, no importa que se escuche el relajo de voces, ¿va? Y que no se entiende, pero usted sí se entiende y usted sí sabe lo que está diciendo, ¿ok? Entonces, por eso yo les pregunto, para que sea más dinámico, ¿ok? Porque yo sé que el trabajo cuesta, o sea, que a veces uno quisiera solo llegar a acostarse a la casa, y los entiendo, ¿ok? Ok, después Okay, affirmative form. Remember, subject.
Sí.
Being past, plus. Where?
Complement.
Ajá, yes. ¿No lleva el verbo también, teacher?
Como en este caso, acuérdese que el verbo to be es el verbo. Ya no necesitamos otro verbo.
En el caso de decir, o sea, yo decía en el caso I was born.
Ese es un adjetivo.
Ah, no, perdón, sí. Sí. No, I was working. Yo estaba usando el verb in.
Ah, pero ese es otro.
Eso estaba pensando.
Ese es el pasado progresivo.
Sorry.
Tranquilo. Eso es otra cosa bien importante, porque recuerden, el verbo to be, o sea, in the simple form, es ser o estar. Yes, y no necesito más nada. El ing, cuando yo agrego después del verbo to be, ing, ya me está hablando de que es progresivo. ¿A qué se refiere? Es algo que está pasando
en el momento.
Ahorita mismo. Entonces, es otro tema. ¿Ok? Pero en este caso, y está bien, o sea, es correcto, pero en este caso nada más estamos utilizando verb to be in the base form. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Past, just past. Okay. I was sick. You see, subject plus verb to be in past plus
complement.
What about in the negative form? Subject
plus
verb to be in past plus not.
Complement.
Excellent, okay? The example says, I was not at home, or I wasn't at home. What about question? In the question, okay?
Verb to be in past.
Verb to be in past. Plus subject,
plus complement, plus question mark.
Plus question mark. Excellent, okay. Were you in Canada? Was David absent yesterday?
Absent? What does it mean, absent?
Absent, ausente. It's like absent. When we talk about, for example, alguien que no estuvo ayer en clase. Let's say Jancy, okay? Jancy was absent yesterday, okay?
Yes.
What about the question in negative form? It's the same, right?
Where?
Where to be in past. Yes, but in negative. Yes, negative. Plus subject plus complement plus
question mark.
Weren't you busy? Wasn't she your teacher last year? And here I have some examples, okay? First, let's see. Janet, read number one.
We were so happy in those days.
Excellent. We were so happy in those days. Excellent. Let's see. Ana Yancy, number two.
It was a sunny day.
Excellent. Thank you. Let's see. Veronica, number three.
Daniel wasn't on vacation.
Daniel wasn't on vacation. Excellent. Thank you. Carlos, number four.
My sister wasn't at the theater.
My sister wasn't at the theater. Excellent.
Theater.
Number five, Flor, please.
The boss wasn't so ¿cómo se dice?
Satisfied
with the work.
Excellent. Number six, Laura.
Mary and Lucas weren't married.
Mary and Lucas weren't
married.
Excellent. Lourdes, number 7.
There weren't any comics on the table.
Excellent, thank you. Carla, number 8.
Which car?
You.
They were so fit.
Uh-huh. Usted solo es Carla. Vamos a decirle Carla Albergue, porque ella sí tiene el apellido, entonces para diferenciarla, ¿ok?
Okay.
What about yes, no question? You see? Para que nos quede más claro, if I want to make a yes, no question with the subject I use was I or was I? Was I or what about with you? Were you?
Were we?
Were they?
Was he? Was she? Was it?
Excellent. Okay. Let's see. Let's read examples. Mateo, number 1.
Were you surprised?
Were you surprised? ¿Cómo contestamos, Mateo?
Yes, I were.
Yes, I
was.
Yes, I was surprised.
Yes, I was. In this case, we can say just yes, I was. Remember, esta es un poco confusa because we ask with you, but in this case, I have to answer using I. And for I use was. Yes, excellent. Okay, let's see. Melida, number 2.
Was Brian from
Brazil? Yes, was Brian from Brazil? Tell me the answer.
Yeah, I do.
Yes?
I were?
Like this? Escríbelo en el chat. O sea, yo quiero que participen, pero yo sé que a veces hay interferencia. ¿Puede escribirlo al chat, Melida? En lo que Melida escribe la respuesta de la number 2, let's see. Ana Yancy, read number 3.
Was that your school?
What does your school? The answer?
Yes, I were.
Yes, were that.
Yes, I were. Yes? Okay, Ana Yancy, I'm talking about the school. Yes?
I were.
Remember? If I want to substitute school, I use it, porque estamos hablando de algo, ¿sí? En este caso de un lugar, de una escuela, ¿ok? Entonces sería yes, it was, porque recuerde que utilizamos con it was, ¿yes?
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Okay, Veronica, Number four.
Was the project ready?
Was the project ready? Uh-huh. Tell me the answer.
Yes, it was.
Yes, it was. Excellent. Thank you. Let's see. Jacqueline, number five.
Was the carpet torn?
Was the carpet torn? Uh-huh.
Yes, it was.
Yes, it was. Okay, number six. Carla Albergue, please.
Were Macy and Tony married?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they were.
Yes,
they were.
Yeah. Excellent. Okay, let's see. Number seven. Number seven, Laurita.
Were they students?
No. Uh-huh.
No, they weren't.
Yes. Okay. And the last one. Okay. Yes. Jancy Mayen.
Yes. Was he your husband?
Mm-hmm.
Question mark.
Ah, yes. That's my idea.
Okay. Yes. Yes, he was.
Yes. Ya lo matamos. Okay, let's see. Yes, I have a reading for you. Okay, you see? Okay, let's see. Carlos, read the first paragraph, please. ¿Logra ver? No.
No.
¿Ahora?
Ahora, thank you.
Now you're welcome.
My name is Anne. Last summer I was in Gran Canaria. The weather was sunny. The palm trees was
yes.
Very beautiful. I was with my two brothers, Mark and Harry. We were camping at the beach. I was 12 years. My brother Mark was 10 and Harry was 10 too.
Mm-hmm.
Because they are twins, it was fantastic to swim in the beach and make sun castles in the sand. My friend was very sad because the holidays was ending.
Ajá. Muy bien. Thank you, porque lo leyó de corrido. ¿Dónde cree que se equivocó, Carlos?
En todo. No.
No, no, no. No, no. No, solo una.
My friends.
No sé.
Esta. My friends. Ajá. It was in plural. Let's see. Oh. Thank you. Excellent. Laurita. Read the second paragraph.
One day we went to the city. There were many places to visit. The supermarket was very big and there was a school opposite the park. The children were there. They were in the park playing. The teacher was looking at them and we were happy because we weren't at school.
Excellent. Okay, thank you. Okay, let's see. And the last paragraph is for you. Angelica.
We was in the museum. There was some pictures and sculptures from Gran Canaria.
Mm-hmm.
They were very nice. At 8 o'clock, we were in the camp again. In the next day, we were at home. I was very sad and my brothers was to me. My brother were to me mother. Mother was in the airport and my father was in the waiting for you. They were very happy because we were at home again.
Excellent, thank you. Okay, let's see. Vamos a leer este último, okay? We were in a museum. Ajá. There were some pictures. ¿Recuerden? Yes, we are talking about some pictures. Vamos a utilizar some word. Yes. And sculptures from Rankin area. They were very nice at 8 o'clock. We were in the camp again. And the mother was
at home.
My mother was in the airport and my father
was in the car waiting for us.
Was in the car waiting for us.
They were very happy.
Excellent, guys. Okay. Este sería un buen ejercicio, ¿saben? Leerlo rápido y tratar de ver cuántos errores se tienen, porque no es que no sepan, sino que es así como que en el momento lograr la lógica. Yes. Okay, let's see. Match the questions, okay? Number one, where was Anne last summer?
Letter C.
What was the weather like?
Letter A. Older were her brothers. They were 10 years old.
Okay, how? Se escucha como que estamos en el mar, ¿verdad? Ya me emocioné. ¿Ok?
Ventilado.
Se escucha como así como... Ventilado el vientecito.
El viento de la playa.
Sí, que igual yo me imaginé eso. Y así, ver la luna, así con la brisita que hace ahorita.
Y el tsunami.
No,
ni en el momento ya, sí.
Realista.
Va, yo solo les digo, yo queriendo que ustedes se imaginen algo bonito.
No, para bajo no de la nube de una sola.
Imagínense no, así, va. No, y algo rico de comer, lo que ustedes quieran, imagínense, algo rico de comer.
Pero ya todo revolcado con el tsunami, ¿ya para qué, teacher?
Es que yo todavía les estoy dando la oportunidad de que ya el tsunami no pasó, ¿verdad? O sea, le vamos a dar otra oportunidad ya, ¿okay? Me arruinaron el momento, no.
Romántica.
Sí, ya. Ya, romántica. Ya se imaginándome la comida estaba yo. Ya se me quitó el hambre, ok, mentira. How old were her brothers? A. They were 10 years old. Ajá, number four, ajá.
The school was opposite the park.
Excellent, number?
La teacher nunca disfruta. Ahora imagínense, si puede decir lo que quiera, no hay problema. Imagínense a la teacher cabal, los niños jugando, la teacher
allá con unos grandes calcetines hasta las rodillas. O sea, porque no se va ni a solear, pues. Que no va a cuidar a los niños, solo a cuidar un suborro. ¿Qué más, Jancy?
Solo dele un celular, Miss, y ya se va a bañar.
No, en mis tiempos como el celular no era tanto, sino que era más que todo solo sentarse en el escritor. Sí.
Hacer un hoyo en arena, Miss.
Y ahí... Yes. ¿Qué más? Ahora sí anda queriendo imaginar cosas bonitas. No, ya que me arruinó el momento. No, Jancy, eso no se hace. Who was looking at the children, okay? The teacher, pobre teacher, siempre sufrida. What time? Ajá, number seven.
Number six.
Ah, ya me quiero ir, mentira. No. Number six. Okay. Did you understand the topic? ¿Entendieron el tema? ¿Sin pena?
Yes, teacher.
O sea, sin pena, yes. Yo no me voy a molestar. No, sino que al contrario, es así como que para que todos aprendamos. Okay. Mélida se me fue, tuvo problema, ¿verdad? Me imagino. Sí, se me fue. Okay. Jackie, ahí sigue. Okay, thank you. Remember, guys. Remember, okay? The first person singular is I. Otra vez, teacher. Sí, otra vez. We use was. Yes. For you, we use
were.
Yes. For he, she, and it.
Was,
yes. What about with we?
We were.
They?
Were.
Uh-huh. Remember, okay? If I'm talking about she, I can say my mother, my sister, uh-huh.
Laura.
Yes, Laura, Melida, Carla, yes. I can use names, okay? Remember that. A veces eso nos confunde cuando vemos oraciones y pensamos de que no va de la misma forma, pero sí va de la misma forma. El we es cuando nos incluimos nosotros, okay?
Nosotros.
Cuando hablo de ellos, pero también me incluyo yo. Okay, remember that. Okay, another thing you have to remember is that verb to be means
ser
o estar. Yes. Okay, when we talk about ser, I'm talking about characteristics. Okay, qualities. What else? About age. Cuando hablo acerca de la edad, for example, I am 22 years old. Mentira, right? Okay. For example, Carlos is 20 years old. Yes?
That's true.
Uh-oh.
How old are you? How old are you?
18 years old. I am 19. No. I am 26.
Yeah, you are young. I am young. 32. I'm 32 years old. Okay. No les pregunto porque me va a decir, eso no se dice, teacher. No voy a hacer que se enojen conmigo. Mejor no les pregunto esas cosas. Okay. For example, when I talk about my state, in this case is I am married. Okay, Jancy is married, yo creo.
Yes, I'm married. Bien married.
Y esa lágrima que le vino a dar.
I'm happy. I'm 24 years for married. Yes.
Oh my God.
My first song is 23 years.
Wow. Yes. Congratulations, okay?
Thanks.
Congratulations. Okay. For example, okay, let's say it's an example. Katie is single, right? Ya se me fue Katy. Ya se me durmió. Mélida, ha vuelto. Ya no me dijo la respuesta. Me quedé esperando.
No,
¿no? Okay. Guys, do you have any question so far? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta hasta aquí, además de lo que hemos hablado acerca del tema?
No, Carla, fell asleep.
Ah, yes, of course, of course.
Asleep. Thank you, Yancy.
Thank you, Yancy, okay? Let's see, let's see. ¿Logran ver?
No, yet. No.
Okay, well. Wait for me. Wait, no se me vaya, no se me vaya. Ando buscando la explanation, yes, of course. Un minuto, voy. Yes. I'm looking for, yes, I got it. Okay, guys, I'm here. Okay. Asleep. ¿A dónde estoy? Hoy sí, creo que sí. ¿Sí puedo compartir? Yes. Solo esto, un minuto. No se me vayan, yo sé que no han comido algunos. Sleep is a verb. What yes. About asleep? What do you think?
It's a noun.
A verb.
Adormitado. No.
An adjective?
A noun? No.
Hmm?
Now?
It's an adjective.
It's an adjective. That's why. Esa es la respuesta. Porque va a sleep. Because
cayó
esa.
Dormido.
Ajá. Yes, in Spanish, yes. Ajá. O sea, yes, you see.
¿Cuál es la traducción en español?
Es dormido, but it's an adjective, okay? Y sleep yeah. Is dormir.
It fell asleep?
Yes. So,
fell? No.
Both. Fell is a verb.
Fell.
Ajá. Fell asleep.
Oh, es cayó.
Cayó dormido.
No. Cayó dormido.
Cayó dormido. Fell es el pasado de, cayó, de caer, perdón.
¿Mm? Fell.
Fell asleep, oh. Yes.
And felt, F-E-L-T, what does it mean?
Felt y sentir.
Sí. Es el irregular.
Es este. Ajá.
The feel.
Ajá. Thank you.
No, you're welcome, Maxine. Es este, okay? Felt. Yes.
It's the path of feel.
Yes. Yes.
Ah, okay.
Another question, guys.
Teacher. Teacher.
Hello.
Entonces puedo decir I am asleep.
I am asleep.
Estoy dormida.
Sí puede, pero no tiene lógica. Mejor si usted dice que su esposo está dormido, sí, ¿verdad?
Ah.
Ajá. Está dormida.
Yo no, Jancy se ha portado muy mal ahora. Yo no quería hacer ese comentario. No. Cualquier queja que tengan con Jancy, ¿ok? Yo no.
Ella es la culpable.
Yo tratando de ser así como tranquila en la respuesta, de no hacerla sentir mal y le.
Ha tomado mucho café, quizá, Jancy. Chocolate, yes.
No, Jancy, este día sí que nos ha quedado mal.
Yes, I'm tired. Sí, vamos.
Yo solo bromeo. Ya ven, si no es así, no se ríen, no se divierten, ¿ok?
Thank you, Jancy.
Thank you, guys. Ok, see you tomorrow.
Bye,
take care.
Bye.
Take care.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye. Good night.
Bye.
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 Good night. Good night.
Bye. Take care.